Hey there, YouTube, it's Math Bowler with my second and final in-person autograph recap video from PiratesFest 2020. This is my Saturday, January 25th autograph recap, so I'm going to go ahead and start right away. I have 62 autographed items, 9 baseballs, 4 helmets, 2 bobbleheads. Well, not 9 baseballs, but 9 autographs on baseballs. 4 helmets, 2 baseballs, 1 ticket, 2 8x10s, 35 trading cards, and 9 of the team issued cards. Combined with my 46 autographs from Friday, we are talking a total of 108 autographs for 2 days. So being a season ticket order helped a lot. And thanks to my buddy Bryan for helping out as we went together and spent some time in the PNC card lounge as well. So we're going to start right off with the order with which I got these autographs for the first paid session here. Season ticket holders got Kevin Newman and Kevin Kramer. But the first one we got was Kevin Kramer, so he seemed pretty interested in signing it. So I went with the blue Sharpie. It just seemed like the right color to use. This brown, medium brown base was a tough one to figure out how to go. So yeah, we got Kevin Newman. And also got him a 4x6 card. Next up in that line was, I think his name is Guillermo Heredia. But yeah, 3 trading cards. And whenever I went to him, he handed me one of these right away. He had a little stack of them on there. So after he signed my 3 trading cards, I went and had grabbed a second one. And the third person from that session was Kevin Newman. And Kramer was looking this over pretty good. He even talked to Newman about it and everything. So that was pretty cool. You know, and Kevin Newman signed it right there. So that's a pretty cool, completed little cute bobblehead that they gave out for an Altoona Curve game. All right, moving on next. Oh, yeah, and a 4x6 card. After that, my buddy and I hit the alumni where we did not get Kevin Young. And we were told Kevin Young was signing, like, everything yesterday. But he did 4 out of 8. So I got 4 trading cards from Kevin Young. So maybe it would have been better if we were able to sneak down Friday. But that's all right. So we got 4 from Kevin Young, who was super friendly. And congrats to him. Along with Matt Capps and Michael McHenry, as they'll be taking over Steve Blass's position. And then in the PNC card lines, we got Jameson Taillon. So the first thing I got was actually this MLB Authenticated game ball that was, he pitched to Miles Michaelis. Oh, I just had a brain fart. Anyway, he pitched it to him. It was a foul ball that he had hit off of Jameson Taillon back May 27, 2018. So yeah, I love the MLB Authenticated game balls. Though I am scaling back a bit because I have plenty, so it's just mainly focusing on players that I want. I did not buy a single baseball from their grab bags. Their grab bags got too expensive anyway. So we got that baseball and 5 trading cards. No, make that 4 trading cards. These are all glossy trading cards, so I'm glad to have gotten them. And that was number 1 out of 250 in the print run there. So that's a nice looking Bowman's Best Rookie. Here is his first Bowman Chrome. And just a couple prettier cards. All right, after that, we then went to the next autograph session, the paid autograph session, got Cole Tucker. And as I approached Cole Tucker, who's the first of 3 people in this session, I told him that this was a game ball that was pitched by Dakota Hudson. That was your 4th pitch ball, so you got a walk. And the next pitch was to Steven Brault, and he hit into a double play. And Steven said that he remembered that, and I said, could you add thanks, Steven? So my intention is to get Steven Brault to sign this and hopefully say, sorry, Cole, or something funny like that, because that would be a really hilarious piece. So yeah, Tucker, 4th ball, walk, next pitch, Steven Brault, double play. Yeah. All right, and then in that session was Jacob Stallings, so got him on this little Sunday helmet. And also in that session was Josh Bell, who signed my baseball. This is a baseball that's not MLB authenticated. I had a great seat. It was pitched by the Marlins. Hernandez to him. Josh Bell fouled it down the first base line. We were fielded by Neil Walker, who literally fired it right into my glove. Bombed the second inning September 5th, 2019. I can't believe how hard Neil threw that into my glove. That was hilarious. So yeah, that was awesome. But then we went for the next session. We stayed for the next one where there was Clay Holmes was first. Signed this debut ticket, which came out looking awesome in that silver paint pen. He added MLB debut, as was my request. And then Mitch Keller was next. This MLB authenticated game ball was a pitch to Tigers' Daniel Norris from June 18, 2019, and he did add first home start, as I had requested. Yeah, he was being nice. Bryan Reynolds, you know, didn't seem as interested in being there, but this is an MLB authenticated double that he had hit in Colorado against the Rockies. I don't even know how, Zenzatala or something like that, back on August 30th. So there's a double from his big rookie year. And then we went ahead and went down to the Pirates clubhouse, and there was Colin Moran and Adam Frazier, which is awesome because I actually had two game balls. I was hoping to get Colin Moran to sign, so yeah, got him to sign this other game ball that I fielded. It's not authenticated because it was pitched to Adam Wainwright to Josh Bell for ball 3 and 4, so it was a walk. Next pitch was a strike looking, and the next pitch was a ground out that Colin Moran had hit to Paul Goldschmidt to end the bottom of the first inning, and Goldschmidt tossed his ball to me, so I got Colin Moran on it. So that was awesome. I was so glad to have gotten that. And then, the more important one, really, this baseball, I had already got signed by Bryan Reynolds at the Hunt Auctions show. It is a Josh Bell walk, Bryan Reynolds single, and then a Colin Moran RBI single that scored Josh Bell off the Dodgers' Caleb Ferguson back on May 26, 2019. So I got Colin Moran to sign. And this one looks a lot better. The other one, when he signed it, you know, he didn't put it on the sweet spot. He put it in just this random side panel spot where that's, like, in my opinion, the worst spot you could put it, the worst panel that you can put it. But then he did this one. The autograph looks nicer. He added his jersey number. So that was really cool to have gotten that. And then Adam Frazier, you know, got three trading cards signed by Adam Frazier, who has developed a little bit of a reputation of being someone who doesn't like to sign, but he signed those three cards. I'm very happy he did that. And then Derek Shelton popped into the clubhouse, and then we were out of there. All right, so then we went and saw, we were heading out to down to the alumni, and we saw Jacob Stallings in the real long tunnel, the hallway, whatever you want to call it, and he signed all three cards. I had, like, all three, like, different versions of his first Bowman rookie card, and he did all three. So that was cool. And we went and saw to the alumni and saw Rob Mikowiak, who, you know, when I approached him, I said, how long has it been since he's been to the PNC Park? He said it's been since 2006, since he was a member of the White Sox, and he was so happy the Pirates asked him to do this. So that was great, actually. He signed all four trading cards. And I got one of these 4x6s. Yeah, we, like, walked right through all the Jason Grilly people who were waiting for him and got right to Rob Mikowiak. So that was actually really, really good how it worked out. So then we went to the PNC Card Lounge to get a little bit of food, and Jacob Stallings was there. So I got him on another card. I have no more cards left of Jacob Stallings, so I also got him on this PNC Park card. And when I went through his autograph line, the paid autograph line, for some random reason, I grabbed a blank one of these. I'm so glad I did. I did not grab any more blanks of those ever, and, well, I grabbed the right one because he ended up signing it. Paid autograph session time was Luke Malley. Signed the one trading card as I was all out of trading cards for him. So, yeah, Luke Malley was there. And then Nick Birdie, who I'm sure I could have gotten more, but I really liked this particular card. So instead of putting my book with four out in front of them, I picked this one because it's really thick and love the Bible verse inscriptions. That's really cool. I'm like that he does that. And also got one of these 4x6 cards. And the third person in that group was Josh Bell. So I had to give him this baseball right away. And this now a completed project. Let me repeat again what this was. This was a Josh Bell walk, Bryan Reynolds single, Colin Moran RBI single that scored Josh Bell off the Dodgers' Caleb Ferguson from May 26, 2019. So this is a completed project, and it came out looking pretty nice there. That will display very well. And so since they weren't watching very closely at all, and we were toward the end of the line anyway, it was the last autograph session, so I snuck them the ball that I had personally snagged. That was the Josh Bell ball 3 and ball 4 walk. Two pitches later, Colin Moran grounded this out to Paul Goldschmidt to end the inning. Paul Goldschmidt tossed to me. So I guess you could argue I need to get Paul Goldschmidt, but I don't really want to aggressively go after Goldie, as a lot of people will be. So anyway, that's awesome. Got that one done. Then we went down to the Pirates Clubhouse where Mitch Keller and Cody Ponce was there. Mitch Keller signed my two trading cards, 2 of 4. So that came out nice. And then Cody Ponce. I had one trading card and then the PNC Park card. And then we went back to the hallway on our way to see the alumni. And Greg Brown was out in the hallway. And I had two photos I was hoping to get signed by him. And oh my gosh, silver paint pen. This turned out looking so stinking beautiful. Raise the Jolly Roger. And then I added this one too. Clear the deck, cannonball coming. That was actually a big time excitement thing to get those two photos signed by Greg Brown, because I really do like Greg Brown. Two more people to show you. They are alumni. Got Craig Wilson again, who appeared to kind of be, you know, he was a little bit over it by then, but he still signed my three trading cards. These were all jersey cards, so they were, or game use cards, however you want to put it. Those came out nice. 4x6 card and a helmet. So I got 5 more Craig Wilsons. And then to cap off the whole weekend, Pirates Fest weekend, got Jeff Karstens, whom I just could not find any trading cards. I thought I had some. Maybe I donated them or just pitched them years ago. Who knows? But had a couple of team cards that he would have played on this certain team. So got Jeff Karstens on 3 cards total. And he had already signed the 4x6 for me when I walked up to him. And a helmet. So of all the items that I got signed Saturday, my favorite was definitely the Josh Bell walk, Bryan Reynolds single, and the Colin Moran RBI single that scored Josh Bell. So that is a completed project right there. So yeah, feel free to let me know down in the comments below what you thought of the video. Feel free to continue to check my stuff every weekend. I post a video sometimes during the middle of the week, sometimes. But yeah, I'd appreciate if you subscribed to my channel. Hope you enjoyed my Pirates Fest in-person autograph recap video from Saturday, January 25th. Take care, everybody.